My name's Jeremy Akers, Jeremy Nathaniel Akers, and I want to talk to you about the bread and butter, the manna of life, the drink, and my two-step of liberating structures, one, two, four, all. One, two, four, all is a little tricky because it is so infinitely flexible and content agnostic. You'll notice that this icon for one, two, four, all bears some resemblance to like the to a dance move, right? If you've ever like sucked at dancing and looked at like how to do a waltz or a box step or some shit like that, you'll see these little feet on the floor and you go, oh, move your feet like this, left foot, right foot, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. That's why I like to say one, two, four, all is the two-step of liberating structures, because I can do a two-step to literally any fucking thing. Regardless of what music is playing that motivates that dance, what question, prompt, or interaction, one, two, four, all is appropriate for it. So how do you use it? Like I said, you can use it for literally anything. You can use it to think about stuff, to generate new ideas, lists, and brainstorm, to answer questions and come to conclusions. It's great for it. And why is it great for pretty much everything? Because it allows us to include and unleash literally everyone. So how do we do it again? We start with some question, some prompt, some topic that we throw at the center of the interaction. And then we invite everyone for 1 minute of silent reflection regarding that question, prompt, or topic. After 1 minute, we join in a one-on-one dialogue where we compare notes about our thinking and we add anything new that comes up in the inspirational session between the two of us. And just take a couple minutes to do that. After that, we move into groups of four. Rather than everyone regurgitating the thing that they just told this other person and boring this other person to death, take the opportunity to share your partner's thinking with this new group. That will give your partner the opportunity to feel that they have been seen and heard, and for you to do a checksum, that you've understood what they were on about, and for them to offer any additional clarification based on what didn't come through or wasn't particularly clear. What we're trying to do in this four stage is synthesize. So keep your eyes peeled for any similarities and differences, especially in your thinking, and try and come down to the essence together of all your disparate thinking. As we move into all, this is where things can get a little tricky, because there's a highest probability of all devolving into an unstructured group discussion or a goat rodeo. And so what we want to do is invite each group to share one idea per group and go around the circle. The key here is to deduplicate. So if the group that just went before you shared your super awesome synthesis, they came to the same conclusion, or a conclusion so similar that it's functionally identical, move on to the next most interesting thing in your conversation. Or just go, nope, what we had to say has already been shared into the middle, right? We're looking for the ideas that the whole group needs to hear. And if that point was already made, then freaking great. Let's move on. And yet, you know, if you have gone around the circle and there was something else that was actually quite relevant and interesting that popped out of your group that hasn't been mentioned, sort of go around the circle again, right? Like I said, the risk is that new ideas start to sort of pop up as you cross-pollinate thinking across groups. And that's fine. That's awesome. What I would say is, rather than turn into a fucking goat rodeo, go back into the top and repeat one, two, four, all over again and generate some new thinking. At just 15 minutes a pop, you can do this thing quite easily four times within the hour, and then you're dangerous. What's great about one, two, four, all is, like I said, it helps us include and unleash everyone. And for someone like me, who's an hyper extrovert, you can damn well believe that if any of these people in a group with me offers me something that I think is rad and totally interesting, I'm going to be standing on the table going, hey, everybody, you need to listen to that motherfucker right here. He's got some fire for us, right? So I'm going to help upregulate the quieter voices in the room. And every quiet voice has an opportunity to be seen and heard. The question that comes up almost literally every time when we talk about 1-2-4-all is, does it work for online calls? And the simplest answer to that question is, fuck yeah, it works for online calls. It takes a little bit of doing. You need to set up some form of breakout rooms or additional channels for those small interactions and group sessions. But the return on that effort invested is actually greater online, because online communication is more challenging and has a higher probability of, you know, people, you know, turning their webcam off and, you know, picking their nose, reading their email, and not particularly paying attention. So because we can sort of like force them into interaction, forceful nudge into interaction, you get a much higher return on effort invested in an online environment versus in real life, so to speak, or away from the keyboard. Let me know if you want. I will be happily do a walkthrough for whatever video platform you're on to show you like where the features are that enable you to set up breakout sessions and shit like that. I guess use the comments or like ping me wherever you find me. You know where I'm at. Perhaps it's interesting to talk about invitations, but I have a whole other video on that. So check that shit out. Track me down. Ask me questions. There's lots of very good recipes about invitations. Take a look at the Liberators post from Barry or Christian. They wrote up a really great article on Medium about great invitations. And like I said, I've got one as well. But any topic that you throw at the center of 1-2-4-all is better than an unstructured group discussion. So again, my name is Jeremy Akers, Jeremy Nathaniel Akers. Thanks for your time, attention, and energy. And I guess I'll see you